If you're in crypto and are leaving your assets in a centralized exchange you get them from, what are you doing? Seriously, get them in a wallet now. We're discussing three types of wallets today and quickly comparing them against each other. So by the end of this video, I hope I've helped nudge you towards a better, smarter path. First of all, there are the hardware wallets, the Trezors and such. These are super safe and quite common among the OG crypto enthusiasts. But they do have downsides to them. They can be super expensive to get, and they will not support all kinds of token standards, so kiss your NFT collection a goodbye. And most importantly, if you lose it, is adieu digital money. Then we have the mobile wallets, and for this video, we're only talking about the non-custodial wallets, since we believe that if you don't own your private keys, you, well, don't own your assets. Key-based wallets are quite common and easy to come by. Most of them are inexpensive, as in free to download on your mobile device, and are pretty safe as well. As long as you keep your private key, hence the key in key-based wallet, safe, your assets should be safe. Forget the private key though, and there's no way to recover your treasure. Not even the wallet provider has a way of recovering it for you. The two-way street of the security of this option. These two options are all well and good if you're just looking to hold your coins somewhere, but they're extremely limited in functionality, because aside from holding your assets, they're only able to execute the most basic of interactions. An Ethereum key-based wallet will only interact with mainnet, for example. There's not much that can be built upon, no upcoming features to be excited about. Well, thankfully, they're not the only options. Smart contract-based wallets, or simply smart wallets, are quite an improvement. They present a robust base for developers to build their own security solutions, such as recovery systems. With these, you can lose your 12-word key and even the device the wallet is in, as you're able to recover your wallet and the assets in it, thanks to recovery solutions, like the one we have in the Pillar wallet. Check it out. And again, it's non-custodial. The team that makes the wallet has absolutely no control over your wallet, which means your assets are forever your own. And since it can be built upon, smart wallets can offer more quality of life improvements, interconnectivity with multiple chains, and evolve with the ecosystem. You can get the best smart wallet by clicking here. You'll experience the safest environment for your assets and a constantly evolving platform that makes navigating the DeFi, NFT, and DAO universes a second nature. And that evolution is driven by you, the community, as the Pillar wallet is a community-run wallet. So come join our Discord and tell us how you want the future of crypto to be. Thank you very much for watching.